So the first thing you'll do once you have finished your hardware assembly is you'll need to flash the FarmBot operating system onto the Raspberry Pi's SD card. To do that, you'll first download the software from our website. So you can find that at software.farmbot.io, and there's a link to download the latest operating system. Once you've downloaded that, you'll want to download a little utility called Etcher, and that allows you to flash the operating system onto the SD card. Note that you cannot just drag the operating system file onto the SD card with your normal file browser, such as Explorer or Finder on a Mac. That will not work. You have to use a special program called Etcher. Once you've done that, you can take your micro SD card and plug it into the Raspberry Pi. And now your FarmBot has all the information it needs to boot up. So we can go ahead and turn on the power. And then we're going to need to get your FarmBot connected to the internet and to your web application profile. So to do that, first you must have a web application profile. So make sure to go to my.farmbot.io and sign up for a web application account. Or if you're hosting the software yourself, then you'll need to go onto your version of the web application and make an account there. Once you've done that, we need to get FarmBot online on your home Wi-Fi network and connected to your web app profile. Once you've plugged in the FarmBot, it will turn on what we call the Wi-Fi configurator program. And this allows you to connect the FarmBot to your home Wi-Fi and your web app profile. Using our laptop, we'll look at the Wi-Fi networks that are available, and we'll see that FarmBot has created a network right here. So let's connect to that network with the laptop, and now we can navigate to any web page. You'll need to make sure that you don't use HTTPS, only HTTP. So you'll see that because we're connected to the FarmBot Wi-Fi network, we've been redirected to the configuration page. And here, we're prompted to enter in our home Wi-Fi network name and also the password so that FarmBot can get connected to the internet, and our username and password for the web application so that FarmBot can connect to our web app account. So let's go ahead and enter in our information. And once you're done, you can press submit configuration at the bottom. And now FarmBot is going to tell us that it is configuring itself. It's getting connected to your home Wi-Fi network and connected to your web application profile. So you'll see that on my computer here, I've now been disconnected from the FarmBot Wi-Fi because it no longer exists. And FarmBot should be connected to the internet and to our web application profile. So let's now go to my.farmbot.io and log in, and we should see that FarmBot is online. Note that with the first boot up, sometimes it can take a little bit of time for FarmBot to get connected and also get everything set up. So be patient and watch the status ticker to see when FarmBot comes online. So that's how we get FarmBot connected to your home Wi-Fi network and to your web application profile. In the next video, we'll discuss all of the different parameters so that you can set FarmBot up so that it's exactly how you want it to run. And we'll then begin controlling it with the controls widget.